YouTube, Optimus Smythe back for another Transformers review. It is a Dark of the Moon toy that I picked up this weekend along with another Dark of the Moon toy, which is Laserbeak, and then that My Little Pony gift set. This here is Dark of the Moon Basic Human Alliance Backfire with Spike Witwicky. Yeah, or at least that's what they call him, Spike Witwicky. I don't know if he actually really is supposed to be in any relation to Sam Witwicky. I highly doubt it. He's not going to even be in the movie. He seriously isn't. None of the Human Alliances, these basics, are going to be in it. They're just part of the toy line. And I know I usually don't get ones that don't appear in the movie, but I got him because he's an awesome vehicle. He's got an awesome weapon mode, and the robot mode isn't really half bad. And this guy looks awesome. He looks like the Master Chief. And I wish I could get my camera to, like, focus or something. That's just going to make it worse if you zoom in. This is not the best camera, but deal with it. But yeah, here's Spike Witwicky. Like I said, he kind of looks like the Master Chief from Halo. Nice articulation, though. Pretty basic for Human Alliances, though. His legs will go in and out like that and turn in a 90-degree angle. The knees can turn also and swivel. Arms are on. They can turn around 360 and go in and out like that. Even the wrists can turn. On these new Human Alliance figures, the wrists can turn, which I'm very thankful for. It makes it a lot easier to adjust them when they're riding on the vehicle, and his head can turn 360. Very nice. Now let me show you how to put him on. You just bring his legs up like that, kind of split them apart to give some leeway when you're fitting him on, and make it so that both of his fists, the palms, are facing down like he's riding on a motorcycle, and then just stick him on here. And what I usually do is I just kind of slide his hands onto the handles like that. It's perfectly safe to do. It kind of stretches him. I don't think they're both fitting on like perfectly, but close enough, and just push him down, and there you go. He's riding it. Now, he does sometimes tend to go up like this. Like that. That's pretty funny, but he rides it very well, though, very realistically. So there you go. And yeah, now I'll start talking about Backfire, I guess. You can see he's got this little, like, exhaust pipe thing on just one side. One wheel in the back, two in the front. That makes it a trike, military trike. Looks like something from Halo, actually. This actually kind of looks like a Warthog. I can't remember which ones are the little four-wheelers, the Warthogs or something else. And then there's the bigger ones, which three people can ride in or something. I don't know. It kind of looks like that the Warthog from the Halo video games, which I'm sure most of you know. And then here are the guns, which you put on it. They've got their clip point guns, which have a ball and socket joint in there that allows you to turn it and bend it up. You can put them on these two little handles right back here, like so. And I usually tend to bend them down and then put them like that. So there you go. Very nice. And I also like to turn them down like that so they're not actually going to shoot Spike himself. And there you go. That's very nice. I really like it. This is such a sweet vehicle. And it's very, the size is very accurate too, at least compared to the Human Alliance figures it is. Now I want to show you something real quick. These are clip guns, which can go on other Transformers that have clip pegs, like Roadbuster here, who's got them on a really good spot, so that you can basically do this. Watch. You just give him the guns, and watch how awesome he looks. And just look at that. That is so awesome. Now Roadbuster's just, like, better. You know that? This is so cool. Yeah, Roadbuster just definitely deserves guns like this. But I am still going to get Human Alliance Roadbuster. That guy looks freaking awesome. But the Deluxe is still cool, and I'll review him too. So let's take him off, and I'll show you how to transform him into his weapon mode first. What you want to do is basically take the whole top of the vehicle up like that and turn it back. But before you, actually, you know what? I should have done this first. Take the rear wheel and split it apart like that and turn them up like this, and then bend this forward, and while you're doing that, bend the wheels back so that they're under the seat of the car. Bend it down all the way, and then put the wheels underneath, and kind of finagle around until... Oh, wait, no, they're not supposed to go there. I'm sorry. They're supposed to go under here. Silly me. Okay, under here, and then put them back together, but you gotta put them together a certain way. Find the pegging holes in there so that it will stick together. And then over here, bend this down, but before you bend it down all the way, come up here and pull this thing out. This is completely optional, but I like it better this way. And then it clicks in there, and you've got a huge barrel of the cannon, but we're not done yet. He's got visible head syndrome, kind of. There's the head right there. You can barely see it, but take his head and pull this whole, like, engine block thing forward. Push the head in, so now he doesn't have visible head syndrome. And it kind of, like, slides into place right there, so it's like an extra gun. And then take this whole front bumper piece, bend it up, bend the wheels back, and here you have a flippin' huge cannon, which I think looks really awesome. It does kind of look funky and odd, but it looks great, actually, and it goes really good with Leader Class Ironhide, which I don't have yet, but, oh well, I will soon, I can tell you that. And yeah, this gun just looks great. It'll really work for Ironhide. When I get him, I'm going to give this to Ironhide. They'd make really good partners, Backfire and Ironhide. And then, you might have noticed those peg clip things are still there, so you can put the guns on it. So now you got like a four-gun system, if that's a gun, right here in your face. Yeah, that is pretty sweet. It's a really cool gun. Now, out of all the weapon modes so far, I'd say, from what we've seen of the Human Alliances, I'd say this one is probably the coolest. I also do like that snowmobile thing. I can't remember his name. It's a Decepticon, actually. How he turns into, like, a chainsaw. That looks pretty sweet. But let's transform him into robot mode now. I did the first part. You put that up. And now, put these down. Come up here. Straighten those back out, and you can see they've already split on their own. Then split this apart and turn them down and around and kind of situate the arms. Yeah, these are the arms. Kind of weird looking arms. It's a kind of weak point. But they've got double hinges here, so you can kind of straighten them out a little bit more. And then push the head back up and put that back into its original position. So there's the whole upper body. Now back here, split the wheel again. And then split the whole body of the vehicle, which will be his legs, and then come up here and bend that part. There's kind of like a double ratchet thing right in like that. Put the legs back down. And here his robot mode is completed, basically. So there you go. There's his robot mode. It's really not that bad, actually. He's got kind of weird-looking hands, although he actually does have humanoid hands. If you look closely, you can just barely see the fingers and thumb in there. So yeah, it's not as bad as it looks. He's got very nice two little nice Autobot symbols right there. The wheels are kind of sticking out, but it's not nearly as bad as the wheels, which stick out here. I usually don't really know what to do with these, so I just kind of keep them like that, I guess. And this leg is a bit clunkier because it's got that little clip that comes down, the light of the three-wheeler. He has beautiful light piping, I'm sure you can tell. Let me bring the light down a little bit more. And yeah, see how wonderful his light piping is? Nice and orange. Although it's orange like he's a Decepticon or he's evil or something. That's kind of weird, but he is an Autobot. You obviously already know that. Now we can give him his guns again. Just simply, you stick them on the side of these parts of the bumper and then put them out to the side. So there he's got his gun. He's not holding it in his hand, actually, but he's holding it somehow. So, yeah. Put the other one on. And here you have him with both his guns, and he's ready to kill. And he looks totally awesome. I highly recommend this figure. He makes a great weapon for all the other mech tech, at least the Voyagers and Leaders, at least. He'd look ridiculous on a Deluxe, unless you put him on top of the roof of a Deluxe. But I don't have Roadbuster transformed right now to show you that. And here's Spike. He has no more use, really, not in robot mode. You can actually sit him on top of the weapon mode, but if it's a weapon, why would someone want to sit on top of it? That would, like, rock you around, and you'd also be in plain view of a Decepticon to get hit by one, so no thanks. So, yeah. But that's it for my review, I guess, you guys. That's Human Alliance Basic basic Human Alliance. Backfire with Spike Witwicky. I highly recommend you guys get this. Not that much. $7.99 at your typical Walmart, Toys R Us, or Target, or whatever. It's very nice, and thank you guys for watching this review. That's all. This is Optimus Smythe, signing off.